1995, 2001, and 2006, the village schedule of the minor irrigation census asks farmers about the water level in their well at the time when the census was being conducted in West Bengal. In water levels. Now, if 15, 16 million farmers or well owners were asked what is the water level, depth of the water level in your well, and if over 4 years, when four different periods, when different groups of people have gone and asked the same question, and if the picture that it throws up is not consistent with the stories that we keep hearing all the time about depletion, what does it tell us? A deeper exploration of what the minor irrigation census.
Let's from a one-point experience. This village that we worked in for about 15 years, typically hard rock. So we were actually looking at the sort of pre and post monsoon levels. And they pretty much followed what you showed in one of your graphs. You know, this is where we are and this is where we need to go. Sort of we need to bring them back. So one of the things we found after 15 years, in fact, I went there very recently, which is almost now 20, 25 years. And what is interesting is once there's a good rain, you know, the first impact that the farmer sees in a well in a rock like a Kasson is that the well water actually comes up. It comes up pretty shallow. But once the sort of recharge takes over, and once it starts dissipating at the aquifer level, and once you measure the stabilizer levels, those levels are different. So very often the farmers, even today, the other day I was in one of the Jason village, and they said that last year, our levels were within 3 feet in the monsoon. And the farmer said that we didn't get a sort of returning monsoon period. So at Diwali time, the level was 8 meters below ground. So, you know, we also need to sort of, so I think a point well taken, we could sort of relook at that as.
Let me sort of just sort of intervene on that. There's also an issue of secrecy to data. The question is, a lot of data is available in the country, but who has got access to it? So they are in the manuscript. So the question is, how can we throw this open? Is basically the community should. So the idea you have part bringing as part of the governance also. That is local level governance. Again, now people are looking at reframing the whole water act itself. Like in Andhra, based on the AP Farms model, they said the panchayat will be the sole authority to decide what is good for them, not somebody based in Hyderabad. So the governance also has to come down. So their individual owners have to have the data, that is at the time of drilling as well as they have to have this data with them. And if they measure periodically, they are going to be better informed. Mm-hmm. And
in slum area, the good city, you're planning the drinking water designing system there, and we identify one location for the well. So the community can, and they ask us, how are we going to go for the one old well, which was, they were using it to very, their forefathers well, and they were having the emotional attachment with the particular well, and then we analyzed the data of that particular well, because after the earthquake, somebody has came from the outside, he analyzed the well, and he gave on the report, so municipality has put the ceiling on the well, and then we analyzed the water sample and discharge, etc., and we find this very feasible for the drinking water. And we give that data to the community. The community went to the municipality, they pressurized the municipality, we want this well only for our drinking water. And today, this particular community in entire city is having the best drinking water system for themselves.
I kind of like to is at a low level. And therefore the need for low cost, more reliable, robust, but more easily accessible instrumentation, where is that sector heading?
Yeah, see, this has made a, it goes into labs. Now, all what you need is just provide one energy meter and create a kind of a simulation on a central server. It costs hardly anything, and we have a model which can be easily scaled up to a very large level. And I'm talking about measuring water at how much is the discharge, what is the dynamic level of the system, what is the efficiency of the pump. You fix the energy problem. Rather, it is one single solution which has a fix for all these problems. and it is all connected on a common thread.
Well, that's the sort of
It is on a grid, you know. So it doesn't matter whether it is two pumps or whether there are 2 million pumps. So it becomes very easy. Like, you can start up with a very small pilot, maybe consisting of 20 pumps or a small village of 50 pumps. Just hook up these 50 pumps, see, study the benefits out of this, and then scale it up in whatever area, whatever way we. So the approach is not from the government side. We can create models of efficiency. Not only in water, you see, there is no question of improving the water without energy. It is totally interlinked. There is no way we can really improve only water or improve only energy. So this is the way we can possibly look at it. And see, the question is, you know, we are also ready to take up, like what Vinita was telling in the morning. We are ready to take up on a partnership. See, so far, till I have come here, I have not looked at it from a social because everything is different. But when you have a social model which would not have been addressed, it's not an opportunity lost for us. Otherwise, this opportunity would have never come in. So possibly, why not we really give it to people like Arkham to really scale it up on a large model? Shikha, would you?
I think discussion about you closing is right. My own understanding was that maybe 5-10 years ago, I was using the data sets which are available in the country for use, essentially. As Shara was asking, we use a lot of minor irrigation census data for even constructing the energy use, how many wells exist in each village. The quantum of water use was one area which was missing. Level is one, water use is another. So the water use, amount of water lifted. Amount of water lifted is coming essentially from the number of wells and an average yield of well yield in that particular village. So there has to be some surveys on this. So like minor irrigation census was providing a reasonable platform on the number of wells as well as probably water yield, saying they have a good distribution of the yield structure in wells, so many wells per yield and so on. But these are need to be revisited. There is no, I think last time we were discussing, one of the aspects which is seems to be missing is there is only one organization putting up this data. There is no third party checking this data. So we need probably a third party agency which looks into this data and validates it, saying that this, then the usefulness of this data becomes much more useful. So that is where we were trying to have a feel that, okay, as an academic, let's go and do measure the data sets and make some kind of a distribution. We found that many places it is good. For example, we tried as part of the groundwater estimation methodology requirement, in fact, there was in the groundwater estimation methodology requirement, it was said that something will be validated. So now all states have completed the estimation, but validation procedure is not taken so seriously.
Yeah.
So what is missing is that, for example, one monitoring station exists in the entire country. On average, maybe 60 to 70 square kilometer could be one monitoring station. Probably I can Najib or. Am I right, roughly? Yeah. So, if that is the kind of on average in the country, but we do not know, like our graph which Himanshu was showing, this particular well in that particular location, we do not know the depth, when it was drilled, where it was, maybe periodically the monitoring stations were modified too. So the question is, which aquifer it is going, etc. is not there. So that's where I think he put a very interesting slide saying that one-time monitoring of the entire country, in some sense, in a large density, maybe 100 crores or 200 crores could fix this problem. Two things will come out very starkly, is that what is this monitoring network, which is important network, which is there for a long time, you can't displace this. How does this monitoring network vis-a-vis several wells around it showing? What kind of a reliability we are talking about? Because there have been enough literature around people saying, okay, people are pumping from a deeper aquifer, whereas monitoring could be shallow. This could be one probable hypothesis, maybe or may not be. So We found in some places that the average is not very bad with respect to the level which the, at least in Karnataka where I, but what I found significantly is that the water level fluctuation from the monitoring stations of the state versus the monitoring stations from a large number of density of measurements around, the fluctuation between pre and pro monsoon is much higher. So that means what we're talking about is delta H is larger. If the delta H is larger, delta H times specific yield would give me more recharge. So the questions which need to be asked is why is the fluctuation, the rise and falls are much higher, which especially the rise, because rise is the one which characterizes the recharge process. So the important implication here is how do we have a one-time gathering of this, make some kind of, this also would kind of help several things in terms of understanding groundwater gradients. We have been looking at all through our methodology in the sector. I'm very happy that Tushar was saying we are champion of groundwater use. But then I think we should be a champion of groundwater measurements and monitoring also. If we have 30 million wells in the country and maybe a few million in US, we should have maybe 20x effort on better monitoring strategies. So, and a lighter side. So what I'm feeling is that probably one of the aspects which probably we need to focus is if we have made a good contour maps of the groundwater by one-time monitoring, because these are not going to change periodically every year. These levels will give us a regional configuration of the good groundwater. So it will help us which watersheds are starved of groundwater discharges, where the groundwater is not even flowing to the streams. Because right now there is a big connectivity between the recharge and discharge.